Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to this week's video of Toddler Tuesdays. My name is Miss Alexa.
Good morning, and I'm Miss Artiaga.
And the theme for this week is how Jesus' power helps us to be bold. Now, Miss Artiaga is going to start us off with the opening prayer.
Okay, boys and girls, let's put our hands together and close our eyes and repeat after me. The sun is up, and I am too. I say good morning, God, to you. Thank you for letting us gather with our friends today. Amen.
Amen. Now join us as we sing a song called This Little Light of Mine.
This little light of mine, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Won't let anyone blow it out, I'm gonna let it shine. Won't let anyone blow it out, I'm gonna let it shine. Won't let anyone blow it out, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine,
for singing with me. Now, let's start our story time of Penelope the Reluctant Butterfly. Penelope the Reluctant Butterfly. Penelope was a cute little green caterpillar with large eyes and two amazing antennae, which along with her 16 feet, helped her get around the forest. All of her friends had dreams of becoming butterflies, but not Penelope. She told them over and over how much she loved the feel and the smell and the taste of dirt. But she didn't really love the feel and the smell and the taste of dirt. She just said that because she was afraid of becoming a butterfly. One day, I'm going to have brilliant colored wings and sail on the winds to the tops of trees, over lakes and mountains to see all the glories the world has to offer, Penelope's friends would say. Penelope disliked the wind as strongly as she loved dirt. Whenever the wind would blow, she would crinkle her toes, every one on every one of her 16 feet, trying to grab hold of the ground as so not to be blown away to who knows where. And as far as flying to the tops of trees, she didn't see the point. There were plenty of leaves here on the ground, and lots of grass too. There was just no reason to fly, at least not any that she knew. And yet, there was a time when Penelope dreamed of flying, until one day, she climbed up way up high on a tree, looking for tastier leaves than those that had fallen to the ground. Then a strong breeze caught her by surprise and knocked her off her balance. And she rolled right off a leaf and fell. Down, down, down. Until then, with a loud oomph, she landed on another leaf, many branches lower. Never again, she said, will I climb or dream of flight. She just hugged the ground, afraid of heights. So when the other caterpillars gathered around the firefly camp at night to tell their butterfly visions, Penelope crawled away, having made a decision. She would remain a caterpillar. She would skip out on the mandatory cocoon-making class and would always remain on the forest floor, safe in what she knew, where she knew she would never get hurt. even though deep in her heart, she knew she didn't really love the dirt. In a few weeks' time, everything got really, amazingly, and utterly quiet. All her friends had made cocoons, and inside each one, behind the silk seams, each little caterpillar was becoming their dreams. Then one day, when the sun came up, Penelope looked to the sky and marveled at the display. The air sparkled like glitter, all orange and green, filled with her friends and their little caterpillar dreams. Her friends called out as they flew overhead, "Penelope, come join us. It's beautiful in the sky, and height is nothing when you can fly." Could it be true, Penelope asked, that the cure to her fear was to face it at last? But what could she do? She had, after all, skipped the cocoon-making class. Her home would now always be here, in the grass. When tears in her eyes started to leave, to her surprise, through a blurry tear, she saw one last caterpillar, Mary, who also looked up in awe. "Why are you here?" Penelope asked. "After all, you did go to cocoon-making class." "Yes, but when it came in time to go in, I lost my nerve because fear set in," Mary said. Then the idea arose within them both. "We can reach our dreams together." "I'll choose a spot," said Penelope. "And Mary, you can spin, and we'll make it large like a house so we can both get in." And that's what they did. And so the day burst open, and out they came, all iridescent and shiny, flying and laughing, their wings in the wind, which now felt more like a friend. They felt lucky to be where they were, when after all, they almost weren't. And they said as they flew, "To me and to you and all who would listen, don't ever let go, even if it's scary in the extreme. Don't ever let fear steal away your dreams." The end.
Wow, Alexa, that was wonderful. Thank you, Reverend Rob, for allowing us to read your story.
Yes, boys and girls, did you know that Reverend Rob is the author of Penelope the Reluctant Butterfly? Now, boys and girls, it's important to remember that God makes us all different so that we can be special in our own way. God makes us in God's image, and God makes you perfect in your own special way. God does this because God loves you and you are very important to God. You should always love yourself because God thinks that you are beautiful and you are special. And even when things can be hard or scary, like Penelope the butterfly, God gives us faith and bravery to be our true selves. Now, join us as we sing, "I've Got Peace Like a River."
I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got got peace, love, and joy like a river. I've got peace, love, and joy like a river. I've got peace, love, and joy like a river in my soul. I've got peace, love, and joy like a river. I've got peace, love, and joy like a river. I've got peace, love, and joy like a river in my soul. I've got peace, love, and joy like an ocean. I've got peace, love, and joy like an ocean. I've got peace, love, and joy like an ocean in my soul. I've got peace, love, and joy like an ocean. I've got peace, love, and joy like an ocean. I've got peace, love, and joy like an ocean in my soul. I've got peace, love, and joy like a fountain. I've got peace, love, and joy like a fountain. I've got peace, love, and joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got peace, love, and joy like a fountain. I've got peace, love, and joy like a fountain. I've got peace, love, and joy like a fountain in my soul.
Wow, I always have so much fun singing that song. Now, Miss Artiaga is going to close us off for the day with a closing prayer.
Okay, boys and girls, let's put our hands together and close your eyes and repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for making us all special and loving us always. We are blessed to be different in our own special ways. Thank you for giving us the bravery to be ourselves. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much for joining us this week, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.